You're watching Sci-Fi4Me TV.
All right, we are at Smallville Comic-Con talking with Manu Intiraymi, who is, of course, Star Trek Voyager and Star Trek Renegades, the new fan production, I guess. You could say it's a fan production. There are a lot of Star Trek alumni that are involved with this. How did you get involved with that project?
Sky Conway, who was the producer on it, who hired Tim Russ to direct it, a good 3 years ago now, just sent me the script, and they had the idea of taking... It takes place 12 years after Voyager got home, so they were going to definitely include as much of the Voyager cast as they could, and the writers had an idea for what happened to Icheb, and he pitched it to me and told me, you know, what the idea was, and I thought it was a really interesting concept. And then I read the script. I thought the script was great. So then I got attached right after that, and they ran the Kickstarter, and finally we shot the film, and it's probably, you know, I saw it in Germany as a pre-screening a month and a half ago, and I think it's about 70%. I think they're almost done, and hopefully people will see it soon.
Now, when you first started playing Icheb, did you have any thought? Now, Star Trek, of course, has been this phenomenon for a long time. You're coming on board not the original, but I mean, it's three or four iterations down with Voyager. Certainly, you're aware that this is going to have a big impact on your career. So when you first started playing Icheb, did you think at any point that the long-term, I don't want to say consequences, but the impact on your career, was that something that made you kind of step back and take a second, or did you just dive right in? It's another job, and let's just do the job.
I was 21 when I got the part, so I wasn't smart enough at the time to think about whether there was going to be consequences, or I was just excited to be on Star Trek. I mean, this is something I grew up watching, you know. I loved all the Star Trek films, so just the idea that I was going to get to be a part of that franchise was exciting, and to this day, there's no regrets at all about joining the show. Did I know what I was getting into as far as how it was going to impact the world and how much of a fan base there is and how it, I mean, it's allowed me to go and see most of the world at these conventions and talking to the fans and the people who love the show. Did I know that it was going to lead to all that and all the stuff that it's led to? I had no idea. I was very excited to do the role, and to this day, very humble and excited and happy that I did.
Now, there are some Star Trek celebrities, you know, Star Trek alumni and just celebrities in general that'll do the bigger conventions, but not too many of them that'll do the smaller conventions. And, you know, Smallville, of course, this is their second year. It's not a very big convention yet. What do you like about hitting the smaller cons as opposed to the really big corporate shows?
Well, there's only a few big corporate shows that I can think of in my mind, FedCon being one of them in Germany. There's a gentleman that runs MCM and Star Trek London. He runs a lot of Collector Mania is the company, and it runs. They do a lot of really huge shows all over Europe. But it's also a company that when I'm there, I feel like the fans are happy that they're not being overcharged. He treats the actors well. But there are a bunch of corporate shows that are so big and so about the money and so not about treating people well. And that it's nice to come to shows like this because you get, first of all, they don't work you to death. You know, at a corporate show, you go there and you're under contract and you get up at 8 in the morning to put your makeup on. At 9, you're going to a 2-hour photo shoot. And then at 11, you're doing an hour Q&A. And then they pull you off to do 8 interviews. And then you head to do 3 hours of autograph signing. And then you're back to introduce a movie and do a Q&A after that. And then you're obligated to show up at the party. So you're all day long working and you're forced to keep that sort of phony smile on your face. Sure. Even if you're tired or you're going through something personal in your life that you need a break from, you don't have a chance to kick back and relax, you know. But these shows, not only are they not such a grind, but they're also neat. You get you get a sense of family, and you get a sense of community, and you get a sense of actually having the time to meet the people that you talk to and get to know a little bit about them, the town, the place, the actual person that you're talking to. For instance, in the photo booth, at a major event, they need to get the people through. So it's hi, how are you? What's your name? Jason? All right, click. 1, 2, 3, next, boom. And they're just forcing
it's assembly line stuff, yeah.
Yeah. And this show, you actually have a chance when people come up to get your autograph, there isn't a handler forcing them to go after you've signed. So you get a chance to actually meet people, talk to people, and have a sense of a connection. And at the large corporate events, a lot of time, you don't actually get that.
So besides the Star Trek projects, a lot of times people are out here to promote a project. What have you got brewing besides Renegades?
This year I have a bunch of films coming out. I have a film called Fifth Passenger that the fans supported. We started it on Kickstarter. We raised $82,000, and then we matched funds, and then we matched funds again, and it's a $325,000 sci-fi horror film. It's an amazing movie. It stars Tim Russ, Marina Sirtis, Doug Jones, Armin Shimerman, and myself, and Morgan Lariah. And I'm really excited for it. I've got a film called Unbelievable coming out, and I'm going to shoot a movie called Tailgaters. But the most exciting project that I'm working on right now that we're actually just started to talk about at this convention is I'm making a project called The Circuit, The Wrath of Khan, C-O-N.
Sure.
And what we're trying to do is we're trying to tell the 10 best stories that have ever happened in 50 years of conventions. So 5 of the episodes are going to be based on a true story submitted by the fans from their point of view, stuff that's happened to them. So I'll be tearing through thousands of submissions. And 5 of the episodes will be submitted by the actors and the people on this side of the table, on this side of the curtain. And the idea is, and the deal with the fans is, we're willing to spill our closets and show everything that happens behind the scenes at these things that a lot of people aren't aware of, as long as the fans are willing to spill their visits. So the whole thing is to spill their skeletons.
Right.
And the whole idea is that we're going to tell our story. We're going to show everything that this is, no holds barred, we're going to pull back the curtain.
And we will have a link to that project in the notes for this video.
And also, if you want to keep up with The Circuit or just my career in general, actually there's 8 films due in the next year and a half. So just go to facebook.com/ManuIntiraymi123, or you can follow me on Twitter @ManuIntiraymi.
All right.
Thanks, man.
Thanks very much for your time. We appreciate it.